Hello guys, very welcome back.
Now we'll see what is the difference between the organized and unorganized sector, right? See, legally, the legal definition or the legal difference between these, the organized enterprise and unorganized enterprise, is even an enterprise has input of electricity and has hired workers more than 10, then he is organized enterprise, vice versa. If there is no electricity usage as an input, then this goes to 20. Greater than 20, organized enterprise. Now there are two other interpretations, that is on the basis of taxation. First, on the basis of taxation, if an enterprise has been registered under taxation, that is GST, then we say it's a formal sector or organized enterprise. This is also known as the formalization of economy, right? The second is the employment quality, and it says that if hired workers have higher wages and better social security like pension, provident fund, job security, etc., then we say that particular sector or enterprise is organized, right? Now let's see what is the ratio of total number of workers in India in both the sectors. So as far as NSSO data claims, in the year 2009 and 2010, it says that unorganized sector accounts for 85% of jobs, okay, and they have used the legal terms, that is the number of hired workers. If greater than 10, hired, when electricity is an input, right? Now there are various arguments, like what if the employment quality is very poor, where to keep that, right? For example, if you take an example of construction sector, right? Construction sector employs more than 10 workers, then people would say legally it's an organized sector. But as far as the quality of employment is concerned, the people are daily wage earners, that is very low wages. They don't have pension, they don't have PF, forget about job security, right? So no way to call them on the basis of employment quality as an organized sector. Definitely they are unorganized sector, right? So to solve this the confusion, government formed a committee headed by Sen Gupta, and it was known as the Arjun Sen Gupta Committee. It looked upon the various facets of unorganized sector and came up with the definition of informal workers is one who is employed in informal sector, and he is employed in formal sector, but the nature of employment is informal, right? So the committee with its data said that 91.2% of jobs in India are informal sector and 92.4% of jobs in informal sector in 2004-05 and 2009-10 respectively. Now there is a counter argument upon this, that there are informal sectors. There can be informal sectors where the quality can be better. For example, if a doctor has hired less than 10 workers, he'll be called an informal or unorganized sector. Still, as far as the quality of employment is considered, it would be far exceeding many of the organized ones, right? So these elite class of doctors, lawyers, chartered accountants, even if we decrease it, most, at most it would decrease at 2%, right? So 2009-10, 92.4 minus 2, it would be roughly 90% jobs still from informal sector. And that's really worrisome, because this will lead to, this means poor quality of employment, and this definitely means upcoming greater poverty, right? This is known as informalization of workers, right? Such a huge extent of population still under poor quality of employment, right? So that was all about the difference between organized and unorganized sectors. Informal, whenever a term comes informal, go for the quality, right? Whenever terms come organized, see it in the worker's point of view. Thank you.